Okay, so what I'd like to do now is I'm gonna go into Python and we're gonna play with the Python library for actually making an HTTP request so you can see how that works and then prepare for some quizzes. So in Python, we have a library called urllib2. There's also urllib1, and this is kind of the evolution of Python in front of you here. We're gonna use two for the most part. Urllib1 has a few handy functions of its own, and when we use those, I'll include those in documents. But anyway, so urllib2 has a function in it called url open, and we can give a URL here to download. So let's say I'm downloading google.com. Actually, I need to make sure I save this. I usually save it in a variable called p for page. Probably not even the right concept, but that's my habit. I always use p when I use url open. So if we run this, we're going to get this p object, which is actually basically a file object. And in Python, file objects, basically what a file object is an object that has a read method. And you can call read on there to get the contents. So I'm going to store the contents in c and call read on p. Okay, so we called url open on this url, storing it in this variable p. And then we called read on the response and stored it in a variable called c. And now if we were to evaluate c, a wall of text, which is what we expect. So this is actually Google's front page. Now, if you remember early in this class, we basically accomplished the same thing using telnet or curl. You can also do the same thing in Python. And so now we have this variable c that has this whole response in it, and we can manipulate it in our programs, which is what we're going to be doing a lot of. Let's take a peek at what we have on that p object. And we can use the dir built-in function in Python to examine an object. Okay, so now we can see the methods and attributes on our p object. And we can see a couple of them that are probably interesting to us. Headers for one, and get URL is another. Get code is probably the status code. And this is generally how I work. When you don't know a library super well, you can use dir to kind of examine the object. So let's take a peek at a couple of these. We've also got a URL one. Let's see what's in there. That's the URL we requested. No big surprise. We can look at the headers. So this is an HTTP message instance. Now I happen to know that this is a dictionary, and dictionaries have a function on them called items. And if we were to run items on this in Python, this is what you can call in any dictionary, items, to view the keys and the values, and it'll actually print them generally nicely for you. We can see all of the headers we got back from Google. Now, this is an actual dictionary, so we can say p.headers, for example, content type. And we can see the content type that we got back from Google. That's actually kind of interesting. We're getting an ISO char set, which is, I was expecting UTF-8, but hey, you learn things every day. So in the future, especially for you Windows users who had trouble using Telnet, you can just use urllib and do the same and get the same answer. And what I'd like you to do now is play with this library a little bit in the form of a quiz.